Bonsoir mes chers amis et bienvenue à cet nouvel épisode de Franglish présenté par Eddie Creator. Hello everyone and welcome to this new episode. Today's title is Conjuguer les verbes du premier groupe au présent de l'indicatif. Conjugating first group verbs into present tense. Avant de commencer, n'oubliez pas de vous abonner à ma chaîne. Subscribe to my channel to watch more videos related to learning French, teaching French and ESL. J'ai divisé cette vidéo en trois parties. La première partie, c'est la définition. Deuxième partie, c'est conjugaison. Troisième partie, les cas particuliers. Stay with us. Let's begin. Let's go to the first part now, which is définition. In this part, I'm going to tell you what are the first group verbs. Les verbes du premier groupe. Les verbes du premier groupe sont tous les verbes qui se terminent en ER à l'infinitif, sauf aller. First group verbs are all the verbs that end in ER at the infinitive form, except for le verbe aller, which means to go. Exemple, jouer. Danser, parler, nager et manger. All these verbs end in ER when they are not conjugated at the infinitive form. That means that all these verbs are first group verbs. The second part now is conjugaison. Here we're going to tell you how to conjugate these verbs into present tense, okay? Very simple, okay? So to conjugate all first group verbs into present tense, we need to follow a rule, okay? So what does the rule say? The rule says that we need to have three parts to have a complete conjugation of the verb. The part one is the subject, or we can just call it personal pronouns, les pronoms personnels sujet. The second part is le radical, the root of the verb. And the third and last part is la terminaison, which means the ending of the verb. Let's begin with the first part now. The first part is the personal pronoun or the subject, or we can just call it le pronom personnel sujet. In French language, we have six forms of personal pronouns, okay? We have three singular and we have three plural, like you see in the picture. So the first personal pronoun is je, that means I. The second personal pronoun is tu, that means you, singular, when you talk to one person, or informal. And we have il means he, elle means she, and we also have en that goes with il and elle, so they take the same ending or the same form. For the plural personal pronouns, we have nous, which means we as a group, and we have vous is used when you talk to a group of people or formal. You all, or you as a group. And the last one is il plural or elle plural. Il avec an S means they masculine, and elle avec an S means they feminine. The second part of the rule now is the root, le radical. The root of the verb, or le radical du verbe, is the infinitive form of the verb without the ER. Like you see with the verbs in the picture. So what's left after you remove the ER, that's what we call le radical, the root. Finally, we go to the last part of the rule, which is la terminaison, the ending. So here, in French language, each personal pronoun has a specific ending. So the ending for je is e, tu is es, il, elle, and en, I told you they take the same form. All three of them, they take the same form. So the ending for il, elle, en is e. The ending for nous is ons. The ending for vous is ez. And the last form is il plural and elle plural. The ending will be ent. I will repeat that quickly in English. So the ending for je is I. The ending for tu is es, il, elle, en, i, nous, ONS, vous, easy, and the last one, il, elle, plural, the ending will be ENT. You need to remember those endings. So let's apply those endings to the root, okay? So basically, what do we do here, guys? We just remove the ER and replace it by those endings. And each personal pronoun has a specific ending. We will use parler to talk or to speak as an example. So you will say here, je parle with an E at the end, tu parles with an ES at the end, il parle with an E at the end, nous parlons with an ONS at the end, vous parlez with EZ at the end, il parle with ENT at the end. I want to talk a little bit about pronunciation now. So for the pronunciation, guys, we have 6 forms, but 3 different ways to pronounce those. So the first one with je, tu, il, elle singular and on, and il, elle plural. For these here, guys, make sure you pronounce only the root, okay? E is silent for je, ES both silent for tu, and E for il, elle is silent also. So for these you say parle. And also the last one, il plural and elle plural, ENT is pronounced like an E silent. So you will not say il parlant or il parlant or something, but the only thing you need to pronounce here is just the root. You do not pronounce ENT. It's just like a silent E. So you will say il parle, elle parle. I will repeat this quickly. So you say je parle, tu parles, il parle, elle parle, on parle, il parle, elle parle. The second pronunciation now is nous. Here the S at the end will be silent, so you will not say nous parlons, but you will say nous parlons. The last pronunciation now is vous. Easy at the end is pronounced E with the accent, the sound E. So you will say vous parlez. I will repeat the verb now, guys, and I will leave a gap of 2 or 3 seconds for you so you can practice with me. Je parle. Tu parles. Il parle. Elle parle. Nous parlons. Vous parlez. Il parle. Elle parle. Let's go to the last part now of this presentation, which is les cas particuliers. So I have selected some particular cases, guys, for les verbes du premier groupe au présent de l'indicatif, okay? So the first case is les verbes qui commencent par une voyelle or an H muet, okay? So the first case is for verbs starting with a vowel or verbs starting with a mute H. So in this case, when you start the conjugation, you do not say je, but only with je, okay? Remember that, not with the other personal pronouns, okay? So with je, guys, you do not say je plus the verb, but you put j apostrophe. Like you see in the example, we have 2 verbs, le verbe aimer, to like or to love, and le verbe habiter, which means to live. So do not say je aime or je habite, but you put the apostrophe and you link the J sound with the following vowel. So you will say j'aime, j'habite. J'aime les pizzas. J'habite à Paris. And also for these verbs that start with a vowel with nous, vous, and il, elle plural, make sure you put la liaison and you pronounce the se sound as ze. So you will say nous aimons. Vous aimez, ils aiment, elles aiment. For habiter, you will say nous habitons, vous habitez, ils habitent, elles habitent. Case number 2, guys, or exception number 2 is verbs ending in CER at the infinitive. Like commencer, lancer. So these, the rule says for the personal pronoun nous, remember, only the personal pronoun nous, not the other personal pronouns, okay? So for personal pronoun nous, we need to put la cd for the letter C. So you will say, nous commençons, nous lançons. If you don't put la CD, you will read it, nous commençons or nous lançons. This doesn't make any sense in French language, okay? So make sure with the personal pronoun, nous, you put la CD so we can convert the que sound into ce sound, okay? So we will read, nous commençons, nous lançons. Rule number three, that's the most famous one, is verbs ending in GR, like for example, manger and nager. So for these ones with the personal pronoun nous, you drop only the R. You do not drop ER and add the ONS, but you just remove the R, we keep the E, and we add the ONS. So we can read mangeons, nageons. Nous mangeons, nous nageons. Let's go to case number four now, which is verbs ending in ET, ER or ELER, okay? So for this one, most of time we just double the consonant T or double the consonant L, okay? With the personal pronouns je, tu, il, elle singular and il, elle plural, like le verbe jeter, appeler. So here with the personal pronouns je, tu, il, elle singular and il, elle plural, we just double the consonant for jeter and put double T, and for appeler we double the letter L and make it double L, like you see in the example. Some verbs, guys, will just require to you to put an accent grave on the E before the T or on the E before the L. Like these two verbs, acheter and geler. For these ones, you just add an accent grave. You don't need to double the consonant. Case number five is verbs having E plus consonant plus ER, like le verbe céder, préférer, or E plus consonant plus ER, like peser. This case is also very easy. We just need to convert the E or the E into an E with an accent grave. So you will say, je cède, je préfère, je pèse. Last case, case number six, here we're going to talk about verbs ending in O, Y, ER or UYER, okay? So these verbs also with je, tu, il, elle singular and il, elle plural, we just transform the Y into I, okay? Like the examples appuyer, nettoyer, so you will say j'appuie, je nettoie. I just want to say something before we end this video. So how do we form the negative form in French language? Very simple. The rule says here, you just need to put the verb between ne and pas. You say, je mange, je ne mange pas. Je parle, je ne parle pas. And for verbs starting with a vowel or a mute H, you just need to put the verb between an apostrophe and pas. You will say, j'aime, je n'aime pas. J'habite, je n'habite pas. Now we need to go to exercice or travaux pratiques. After we explained how to conjugate first group verbs into present tense, guys, I want you to apply these rules in this activity. So you have 20 sentences. So you need to pause the video and copy all the 20 sentences on your notebook and conjugate the verbs in brackets into present tense. You have 20 minutes to finish that, okay? It's 1 minute for each sentence. Good luck. That's it for today, guys. I hope you liked the video. N'oubliez pas de vous abonner à ma chaîne et n'oubliez pas aussi de partager cette vidéo. Merci de suivre avec nous. J'espère vous voir bientôt dans un nouvel épisode. Thank you for watching. Good luck, everyone. Au revoir et à la prochaine.